You're listening to the SWN podcast.
And this is SWN.
Welcome to SWN.
Skull! Skull! Skull!
This is SWN.
And this is the Scottish Wrestling Network.
Where Scottish wrestling lives, I guess. Is that a tagline? I guess. I don't know.
Hello and welcome to the latest edition of the SWN podcast. I'm your host, as always, Billy. And we're on the road. We're back on the road. This is the first road trip of the new season. It's no longer an on-tour season, so don't worry about it. I will not be saying it's an on-tour season and then only do like 8 episodes on tour and then another like 30 interviews. Because that would be madness to do that. Anyway, if I haven't already said, my name is Billy, and it is the SWN podcast, season 7. And this should be the second episode, I think, of the season. Which is weird, because it's the second episode being recorded as well, because the first one I recorded was the interview with Keita Murray. So we did that one. But we're off to Peterhead today for WrestleZone Blootoon Wrestling Extravaganza at the Palace Hotel in Peterhead itself, which I'm really looking forward to. Last time I was in Peterhead was for Community Pro Wrestling last year, and I had a blast. I was at the football club, and it was really easy to get to. It's one of those places where I used to not used to go regularly, but used to be near enough because I used to live in Newport Sligo for a bit, and I had been to Peterhead for a long time. Went there, really nice, went to Bon Bon. I'm hoping today, depending on time we get there, it's 2:30 just now, so should get there in plenty of time. I'm going to go and see if I can get into Blootoon and hopefully pick up a couple beers, you know, for future episodes, because I do have some episodes planned in the near future that we could possibly have a wee drink in. I've got a Friday night recording soon, and I'm hoping to do a Saturday night recording, so that's fun. But the show itself, last time we did a road trip, it was Granite City Showdown for WrestleZone. We're back for Blootoon Wrestling Extravaganza. Next one will be Regal Rumble, and then it'll be Aberdeen Anarchy. That's what I've got tickets for, and that's what I'm planning to go to. Oh, good Discovery Wrestling as well, Discovery Wrestling in April. So I've got a show a month at the moment, which is nice. It's a nice little trend to have. I think by my reckoning, Aberdeen Anarchy this year should be like my 97th wrestling show that I've been to ever, which is very cool. That's including one tribute show and four or five WWE shows. So that's cool to kind of maybe hit 100 by the end of the year. If we get a couple W3L shows, Community Pro come up to Peterhead later in the year, maybe go to that. And maybe if WrestleZone come to Keith or Bucky, that would be even more amazing, because maybe my 100th show would be my son's first, which would that be amazing? You know, as a wee little checkpoint. There's a coin somewhere in this car and it's moving. I don't know where. I'll find it sometime. Anyway, yes. So this is we're back in the season, back in the saddle for the podcast, and it's one of those weird ones where I was like, the show I was going to run this season from March to July, finish my birthday, the day of birth bonanza, and then take a break again. But when I did the maths and worked out how many episodes that would be, if I was doing one a week, that worked out 18 episodes, which is a very, very short season. So I think we're just going to run this for the rest of the year, run this particular season till December. And then come back in for season 8, starting with the year-end awards. I think that's my plan right now. Things are always subject to change, though. You know, life and all that kind of stuff. And whether I get enough guests for that time as well. I've got a lot of returning guests in the just waiting to arrange a date for. and I've got some guests that are coming back that I've already got arranged, which you can check on Patreon. Actually, by the time this comes out, you'll know what they are anyway. So it'll be Tom Atlas, I've got him coming back, I've got Ian Skinner coming back, Charlie Anderson will be recording next week, as of this recording. And I've also got a couple of other folk that kind of know where I want to slot them in. It's just that timing of getting them on the show and recorded. So I've got plenty of emails being sent and all that kind of jazz. It's just a case of responses and then getting them into the old recorded book as well. So there's a lot to do for a podcast I really enjoy. I really missed the break I had between it. It wasn't that big of a break to do podcasting, because I really just miss doing it. I quite like doing the podcast. What I started doing, I don't know if I'll have that many. Hopefully I will still be doing it by the time this comes out, but I really enjoyed doing the wrestling scene thing for YouTube. Just a quick 15 minutes where I talk about shows that are coming up at the weekend that you should go check out. Have I added a results section to that? I don't know, we'll find out soon. I find it a bit more difficult now to get results, because I think a lot more promotions are trying online content, which is something I've shouted for. So it's kind of, in one way I'm like, I wish I was getting results quicker, or places to be more receptive to handing out results to shows afterwards. Obviously I don't want shows before, I don't want the results before. But I've wanted more Scottish wrestling as online content, so if I'm getting that, it's just one of those things where I've found the con on it, pros and con list. But the pro is you get to see more wrestling. I hopefully will get to see more wrestling online and be able to provide more review content, because I'm still working my way through Combat League wrestling. I think I'm just about finished as of recording. I'm just about finished 2022 season. I think about two shows. I think it's just the Halloween show and their finale that I've got going on. And then I start 2023 and hopefully finish that before the end of the 2024 season. That would be good. I'm just very slow with doing reviews. I was one of those things where I'm really fast doing them. I do loads in a very short space of time, or I will just take forever to do them. So it's much like probably the one to watch list is still not out by the time this comes out. I'm almost going to guarantee it. It's because there's too many people I want to put on there, and I don't want to offend anyone by not mentioning them. And I know there's quite a delicate balance at the moment in Scottish wrestling, especially that people will think that I'm purposely forgetting them or that. And I implore you now, I probably have just forgotten. It's not going to be I'm not going to do it on purpose. I'm not going to go, this person's definitely not on the list because they work here or they do that. That's probably not the case. I would say 99% of the time that's going to be the case. But, if you want to be offended, be offended. Blootoon Wrestling Extravaganza. That's what we're going to see today in Peterhead. I'm looking forward to the drive, actually, because I can't remember what I did last time when I went to Community Pro, whether I took the coastal route or if I took the A96 and turned off somewhere to go to Peterhead. But I'm going to take the coastal route today anyway, so they'll be going through Cullen and Banff and Macduff and all that kind of stuff, and Newport Sligo, where I lived for a couple of years. So I'm looking forward to doing that drive. I used to just commute every day. I worked in Elgin. I still work in Elgin, but I used to work in the office in Elgin, but I lived in Newport Sligo. So I would do about 105 mile round trip every day. So it's cool to do that, and I guess you're wrestling in the middle of it instead of doing an 8-hour work day of something super monotonous. So I'm excited for that. So I've got that going on. Like I say, all this stuff bomb on. I've been given a list by Kelly, so got a list of things to hopefully pick up. I'm going to say it now just in case I forget. It's the little fizzy watermelons, jazzies, Oh god, there was something else. Oh no, I've blanked. I'll remember by the time I get to Peterhead, it's all good. And then I'll go get a little bit of food. I kind of know where I'm looking to go. Obviously do some charity shop diving. I love a bit of charity shop diving. See how long I can really go because you know, fun being almost mid 30, I'm 33, I've got gout, so walking isn't really too much of an option at the moment, which is fabulous. So I'm going to hopefully, the plan is I'm going to park at the Palace Hotel and just work my way out, because I think two streets over is like your main street where all your shops are, your street shops and what have you. So that's my plan. Whether that happens, we'll find out. Possibly you'll find out in this episode whether that happens. And then go see some wrestling, and then come home with a load of sweeties and hopefully some lovely wrestling memories. Let's look at the card then, because eventually I've waffled on 10 minutes and I haven't actually spoken about what's actually on the show. So, on the show, Triple Threat Match is your pre-show. It's Chris Archer versus Evan Young and Oliver Green. A match I'm really looking forward to because there's a little bit of story here. Ollie and Evan have got wins over Chris Archer. Chris Archer's the vet. He wants to show these youngins a thing or two. And there we go. Easy enough. It's going to be fun. The pre-show matches that I've seen, I haven't missed that many WrestleZone shows recently. But the pre-show matches are always just a good lot of fun. Introduces the wrestlers really well. And then hopefully if you see them on the pre-show, they're on the main card like Ollie and Evan were for Granite City. Wrestling Showdown. It just gives you a little bit of an introduction to them for an extra couple of quid, you know, and you can also get your seat. I've never been to the Palace Hotel for wrestling. I've never been to the Palace Hotel full stop. So I'm interested to see what the setup is as well. There's going to be stairs, isn't there? There's always stairs. It's WrestleZone. I love a bit of stairs to go see some wrestling. How many venues don't have stairs that I've been to recently? Daidston. Is that it? Daidston. No, Curl has stairs. Well, it's been Curl Daidston has been kind of the main venues recently. Avery Rooney did it, I'll give him that. Actually, no, I'll take that back. There was a good streak of me going to WrestleZone shows and you had to go up a million bloody stairs to actually get to the show itself. The Northern, great atmosphere, narrow as fuck stairs, you know? So you had to kind of balance it by going, yeah, this show's really good, there's great atmosphere, there's a lot of roar and all that kind of stuff. But by God, some of that stairs got a bit ordinary and tight to try and get up at the time. I still remember 2015 Christmas Chaos comes early with Mick Foley and tried to get up the stairs to a little room in the Beachleisure Centre for the meet and greet. And my God, there were some smells in that particular queue, but we move on to hopefully better smelling times. Fingers crossed. So yeah, it's a pre-show. Looking forward to that one. I mean, I've done a whole preview on YouTube and everything for the WrestleZone podcast. So that was a bit more researched and that. I love doing the WrestleZone podcast. I'm just very aware whenever I do it, it always goes out of date really, really quickly. And not just because I put it out on the Wednesday or Monday or Wednesday, and then the show itself happens on Saturday. But usually I'll do it and then a promo comes out which kind of negates a point I made in the podcast. Like for the WrestleZone podcast this time, it's a really rambly bit, I'm so sorry. The WrestleZone podcast this time, I did two bits. One was, I was selling the ticket link, and then as soon as the day after I put out, the show sold out, that's fine, it just happens. And then the other point was for the Omar Mohamed Zach Dynamite match, which I'll just talk about that one now. I said the Dynamite doesn't care probably doesn't care or pay that much attention to Omar. He's got bigger, better things to think about in his mind. And then as soon as I put that out, or as soon as I put it up on Patreon and I had it all sorted, a promo came out pretty much of Dynamite going, "Oh, you've got my full attention." I was like, "Ah, shit. Oh well, you know." But that's just the nature of the beast when you're trying to put out podcasts in plenty of time. And what is this fucker doing? You have missed the lane, sir. It's a lorry. So that happened. But Omar's Dynamite is a match I've really wanted to see. I don't know if they've had a match in between or had interactions in singles action between, but I know they had a match at Trade Center takeover. And it's one of the few matches I missed that day. I think it's on his YouTube channel. So you can see it. You can see it in like a portrait mode. So I got to see a bit of it. It was great. I really enjoyed it. But now that they're in this more evolved state of both of them, it's going to be an absolute cracking match because Dynamite's on a different level right now. He's just, you put him in the ring and it's hard hitting. Is strong style the word you use for these kind of things? It's strong style, it's just hard hitting, snug. He likes to proper like lay it in but also take the punishment at the same time. Omar is fantastic, he's sensational. I've really enjoyed Omar's work at the moment in wrestling. So I've seen them both going at it as a match that I'm super interested in. It was even one I think almost, we couldn't get childcare for today, but it almost had Kelly going, "You know what, well, let's see if we can get someone to look after Jack for the day." But ultimately we could get childcare. But this is a match, this is a draw match, this is a match that you want to see, Dynamite and Omar, so I'm looking forward to. I'm wondering if because it's got a name, the show, like Blootoon Wrestling Extravaganza, whether they're going to try and put this on DVD or if we're actually going to see a couple of these matches, because WrestleZone, love them. Love them in promotion, great welcoming promotion, enjoy going, love going to the shows. But I find their online content is great promos, loads of promos, fantastic. You usually get a promo per match. But until like, there was a big gap between them putting out full matches, you know, it wasn't, because they're putting out DVDs and that, but I think tail end of last year, they put out a couple of matches, and I want to see them do that more, you know. If it's not, I understand if it's going to be a DVD, I absolutely understand, but DVDs are becoming a dead media. Physical media is still a thing, so I understand they'll still do the DVDs, but I need to get some stuff online, get more stuff on YouTube would be amazing. It must be available, because how would possible wrestlers be able to see it for feedback if not it is available somewhere, you know? And they've got a big back catalogue. Once the DVDs run out, like your Amity Anarchies or that, surely there's no stopping them putting that on a Patreon on a subscription basis, because I would watch older shows just to refresh my mind, do some like retro reviews and stuff like that. I would do that easily, and I would do it at some, you know, £5 a month or something like that. Absolutely, I would pay that and be able to see some back catalogue content for WrestleZone. So you know, just put it out there for anyone listening. Love it. I would love to see that. Because there are shows that I've been to and I've enjoyed, and there's loves ones that I'd like to revisit, like that Mick Foley one, Christmas Chaos. It was available on DVD, I think. I'd love to just be able to go, right, I really want to watch the show, I'd have to go dig out the DVD for it, or I could go to YouTube, hit my subscriptions, there it is, found it, ace, grand. But that's just me rambling now. So Omar versus Zach, excited for it, I'm absolutely buzzing for that match. That's other than the two championship matches, it's probably one of my matches I really want to see. So that's three. All these matches I think are going to be top drawer, but the championship matches and Omar and Zach are the ones that I was like, yes, give me that. Give me those matches straight away. Other singles match on the show is Captain Al Sterling versus Mickey Vago. Mickey Vago, of course, last minute guest on the podcast. Well, not last minute. I organised it in good time. It just didn't make it. It went finale, and then it went epilogue, encore, extra. So he slipped in the interim period between season 6 and 7 with an encore episode. It was totally organised, but it was organised after I put out the 6 seasons in a t-shirt. So that was really awkward for me. But his name's already on it, so it's all good. The only one that was awkward really was Frank Gallo and our Drew Marshall, because they were the other two like appendix episodes. But if I do a future roll call, I did have a roll call t-shirt briefly, but I took it down. So if I do another one, then those names will be added as well. This is going to be a riot. This is going to be fun. It's going to be funny. Captain Allen is fantastic. Vago is probably thanking his lucky stars, his long hair, so he can cover his face from laughing. Because these two have had tussles before over the Tri-Counties Championship. And also they were in one of the last official matches in WrestleZone. Unofficial matches in WrestleZone before the pandemic. And a match that probably never seen the light of day from what I read and what happened during it. It was nothing like that, you know, what came out later in 2020. But probably wasn't the best course of action at the time when we thought that the pandemic was just going to be 3 weeks off and then we're back to it. And not 2 years are we getting Christmas this year? You know, yeah. It's just going to be a bit of a riot. I'm interested to see if we're going to see a bit more Tommy Raiden. He's not. I don't think he's got a match. He hasn't got a match on the show. So I'm interested to see if we're going to see a bit more Tommy Raiden involved. It's going to be a good bit of fun. We've got the tag team match. We've got a couple tag team matches, actually. We've got, first off, Damien and William Sterling against the team of Bruiser Brad and Ryan Riley of the Foundation of the Future. Another matchup that I'm interested to see. I'm interested to see what the dynamic is here. I have my theories, my wild theories about how this is going with what we're going to see in relation to Avenue Anarchy, whether this is going to be another bit with the Foundation cracking the Foundation's WrestleZone. I'm interested to see if we're going to see any developments from that. Are we going to maybe see Scotty Swift make a tease to return? Are we going to see the Foundation interrupt other matches because they've just liked it just to come out and attack people recently? And yeah, it's good. It's just there's a lot of question marks over this particular match on what's going to happen and what's going to go down. But that's where the interest lies. You go to these shows. I am terrible. I've said it many episodes that my predictometer is woeful when it comes to WrestleZone. I have theories, and sometimes they come out, sometimes they do, but generally they do not. And I don't know whether outside of wrestling being real kind of thing, whether they read my theories and go, well, he's guessed it, let's just do something else. And I still enjoy what comes out of it, but most of the time, I think maybe once or twice it's come out and you go, yeah, that wasn't good. But generally, it still slaps. Is that a phrase? It still slaps. I want to know how this is going to start affecting Avenue Anarchy plans with the Foundation of the Future taken. Apart the Foundation's WrestleZone. That's where all my excitement lies in that particular match. It should be good anyway, because we get Damien. Damien and the Foundation always work pretty well together. I don't know how much William's going to do, but we'll see. We'll see on the show. I'll give you a running commentary. I'll do a write-up. A write-up should be out by the time this episode comes out. I bloody hope so, because otherwise I'm going to rely on my memory, and that is not a good thing to do, not a good thing at all. If I don't have a write-up done by the end of the week after the show, then good luck. if we don't see the show, if we don't watch it back, like for Arthur Mania, for FCW, there's no chance I'm going to remember what happens in the show. I will just tell you my thoughts and feelings of, I like this one, I like that one, didn't like this one, you know. What else we got? So we've got the outfit in non-title action, Ted O'Keefe and Murphy, Ted, my big pal, my medium pal, taking on the Wallies, Brian Tucker and Reese Dawkins. Is Brian Tucker going to get attacked by the Foundation of the Future? That's been my guess, so probably not. So with that, I think this is going to be kind of maybe a foregone conclusion of the outfit winning, but you never know. Dawkins and Tucker have some wins somewhere, somehow, in a handicap match. They've got some wins under their tag team collective belt. So if they get a win, maybe we'll see them get a tag title shot at the Regal Rumble. You never know. We don't know. We'll find out soon. And two title matches. So we've got Conor Malloy going after the Tri-County Championship against Caleb Valhalla in a rematch I'm excited to see. They had a great match at Station Hotel Showdown at the start of last year. It was really good. It was a really good match. A match that wasn't advertised. It happened due to circumstance. And we got a really good match. So I'm excited to see, with a little bit more time, how these two guys are gonna go for it. We get to see Conor. Conor's no longer like the yeah, come on guys, high five, you know, blue-eyed white meat baby face. He's now this smarmy, swaggering heel, you know, all that kind of stuff, smugness and the like. So I'm interested to see how all that comes into play. We get to see that. Caleb being Caleb, I love to see it. So we'll just continue on that. That should be really good. And then the main event, I always assume the title, but the heavyweight title is the main event. We get Lost Boy Aspen defending against Ronan King in a match that I thought would be happening at Arena Anarchy. So maybe we will see. This will be another chapter in the story, and with shenanigans all involved, we may see a rematch at Anarchy. If we do, I saw the size of the. You know what? Here's my bold prediction. If Aspen retains, then Ronan wins the Rumble. That's my bold prediction anyway. But they will have a rematch, and it will be in the cage, in a steel cage, the blue bar cage, for the title. So it keeps out Connor and keeps out Caleb. So there you go. There's my not-so-bold prediction. We're going to see whatever happens. There's going to be some shenanigans involved in this match tonight in Peterhead. And then Ronan's going to win the Rumble, and we're going to see a rematch at Anarchy, and it's going to involve the steel cage. There you go. There's that. Maybe have, what's his name, Lee McAllister. He can be the referee. Just kind of do like Damien and Sean Johnson had a steel cage match for Avenue Anarchy at the Beach Ballroom. I'm trying to throw it out here. 2018? No. Yes? Yes. Go 2018. Yeah, that sounds right. I don't know if it is, but it sounds right. 2018 was at the Leisure Centre, so yeah, I'm going to go 2018. So, well, there you go. So if I predicted it right and you've gotten this far, ace. If I've predicted it wrong, then that's just usual. Just usual capers when it comes to me at WrestleZone. Yeah, so Peterhead, Blootoon Wrestling Extravaganza. I'm excited for it. I love a bit of wrestling. Outside of this particular road trip, and I'm trying to think of any more updates I can give you. I've already told you who I've got at the moment scheduled for episodes, but that information should be out by the time that this episode goes out properly, because I'll have to do the old post to get some questions in and etc. So we've got that. Other than that, I mean, we've got a couple of road trips at the start of the year. We've got this one, and we've got Regal Rumble, which Kelly should be involved with, so she'll get a wee road trip bit on the way through, and she can do some talking while she's driving, and you can look at my lovely face while that happens. I've got Discovery I don't know how that's going to work for the road trip. I've got a kind of idea because we have to drop off Jack and then take the train down. So I think in that interim bit between the drop off and the getting to the train station, we'll do a little like 10-15 minute bit about it, and I'll try and keep up with the storylines for Gellia's benefit, and so she knows what to expect. I'm really excited for that. I've wanted to tick off Discovery Wrestling for the longest time, and it just happens that we're down in Edinburgh to see Hamilton on the Saturday, and I was hoping, and I left it little bit later than I would like to organise hotels and all that kind of stuff, because I was hoping we'd either get a Friday night disco or a Sunday show, and I waited, and it was announced it was going to be a Sunday, which is perfect. Actually works out even better than I wanted it to. So we're staying down for Sunday night and back up on Monday as well. So I'm getting to, Kelly's getting to take off Hamilton. This is what I wanted to do since Hamilton came into her life, and now I get to take off Discovery Wrestling from my checklist of companies. I've ticked off a fair few in my time. Some still active, some probably shouldn't be active, but I've done pretty well. There's still a couple companies that I know that I want to go see. It's just a case of, you know, it's travel costs, timing. As I think may have mentioned in the Vago episode, I like coming home. Like, it's different if it's me and Kelly going to a show together, because selfishly, if something happens with Jack, it's really exciting, we both miss out on it, so it's even. But if I'm away for a night, overnight to a show, and I don't see him in the morning, and he says something exciting, and I don't see it, but Kelly has, I feel like a bit bummed out by that. So I like to come home. I like to make sure I'm there in the morning to see him and do all that cool stuff. You know, fatherhood has really made me very grateful for my own bed. Not that I didn't love my own bed already. So with that, because I'd love to go to see Pro 2, I'd love to go see Power Pro, Girders, Valor, you know, all these kind of places. And it's just a simple case of time, money, and all that kind of, all that jazz. So anyway, so I've just passed Cullen. I'm still rambling on at this extended episode, because I will then do the montage. I'll do a little bit when I get to Peterhead, maybe. Possibly when I had a sweet victory and show off the sweets I got at Bonbon. This is a great advertisement for Bonbon. They should really get on this and give me a shout for a sponsorship. So I'll do that, and then montage, then home time, and then back in the studio. That's how these work, isn't it? Should it be? Maybe. So, I'm going to leave you with that. Haven't missed out any of the matches. Triple Threat. Foundation versus WrestleZone Foundation. We've got a non-title tag match. We've got Omar, Zach, Alan versus Vago. Tri-County's title match. Undisputed title match. So, no, I've remembered all of them. So, go and, I don't know. By the time this comes out, I think Regal Rumble will probably be sold out, so I can't really shill those tickets, but we'll have a WrestleZone podcast out that week, probably. Other than that, let's see how we do. I'm gonna go to Peterhead. I'm gonna just go enjoy some wrestling. So, see ya.
2 hours later.
Ignore the plastic tool bench that's behind me. I had to stop on the way. Marketplace, Facebook Marketplace is a very dangerous place. But no, we're in Peterhead. It's 5:30 now, so I'm just kind of taking a wee sit down before I go into the queue, you know, for the old gout, because I'm a war vet from the Second World War. Who gets gout nowadays? It's just ridiculous. So fed, watered, purchased things and stuff. Didn't get the Money Cup Brewtoon. Gutted, but got a little tasty of it, and it tastes like Murray Cup if it was a lager. That's all I could really describe it as. But I got a couple cards anyway, mainly because I'd use their toilet and I felt really bad about it if I just left without going, ah, you know what, I'm taking a piss in your toilet and I'm not going to buy anything. So I got a couple cards, I got a couple things from Bon Bon, as I said I would. I think I got what I remembered was Jazzy's and watermelon things. God, I hope so. So yeah, looking forward to tonight, Peterhead. Looking forward to going to the Palace Hotel. Try to park there. No parking, but there's a car park across the road, which is what I'm in just now. 50p for half an hour, because I got here at 4:30 and parking charge ended at 5:00. So there you go, 50p. It's been a rather expensive day. But yeah, looking forward to this. Looking forward to the show. Not much more I can really say about that, so I'm gonna have a wee hype of the Dr. Pepper here. Just let my phone tick over to like 90% and then head across the road to the Palace Hotel. So the next thing you will see, hopefully, is a montage. Fingers crossed. But no, this has been a good day. It's been a good day. Let's see how the show goes. So next, montage.
No exposure, I just wanna be a loner. Some can't stay sober, looking over all their shoulders. Like moving boulders just to get out of the home. It sucks, I've had enough, I don't wanna feel the stuck. Under the rug, all my problems that I saw. Who's a good friend of me? I need purpose to make it all worth it. I'm still searching and I'm still learning. I want a life that's filled with memories, not a life with a bread in front of me. I need focus, keep me remote. This psychosis, if I keep moving. I got nightmares in my head, I fear that the thoughts build up until I can't hear. That my mind fills up into a creature, and it haunts me so much deeper. I've been feeling weird, I can't seem to focus good enough. Nothing's really clear, sometimes it could be a little tough. I just need to feel like the end's in sight for me.
Hello, hello. We're back from, thrilling montage. I can barely see because of this blooming massive tool bench thing. which I'm sure Jack is going to bloody love. Anyway, we're just out. I didn't hang about tonight. To be honest, my foot is absolutely in agony. I hate gout. I think that was the 3 mentions of gout now. So I've just left the venue like pretty much as soon as the show finished to go home. I have not set sat nav, so I am assuming away I go, which could go really well, really, really badly. But what a show tonight. So Peterhead, yeah, just a fantastic show. I enjoyed just about every minute of it. It was actually just about, I think I could confidently say I enjoyed every minute of it. It was just a really, really solid show lineup. There wasn't any like big proper surprises, but when I come to think of it, I'm using the old logic brain here, it was essentially a charity show, but it had some good through line storylines to go into Regal Rumble. But it was still just great. It was really good. So it kicked off with the triple threat match. We had Chris Archer defeating Oliver Young and, sorry, Oliver Young. Ollie Green. Sorry, I do know your name, Ollie. Ollie Green and Evan Young in a really, really fun match. It started off with Archer trying to avoid the action, and then eventually did get involved. There was a couple cool little spots where Archer would try to interrupt and end up getting thrown out by Young and Green. So that was a lot of fun. Archer picking up the win. It was great. He used the chain to knock out Ollie Green and picked up the win. So that was a nice little opener. It was really fast. I felt like the time between that match finishing and the doors open, the first bell for the main show, felt like ages. I don't know if it was a case of it just did, or time just moved slowly. But it was a hell of a lot of fun, that opening match. The main show opened up, and I'm just using my recall here. So I think it was Omar Dynamite, I think, opened the show. I'm sure it did. This is one of the best matches on the show. It was fantastic. I've seen Omar wrestle like pretty much from YouTube at the beginning. I always bring up Action Academy because it's always a great reference point, whether he wants to remember this particular show or not. But it's always a great reference point to see Omar as that skinny kid, not really knowing what to do, and then to see him now, he's getting jacked as well. He's confident. He's got this great way with the crowd. He's got these massive facials as well. They just resonate, and he's a fantastic wrestler. And put him in with Dynamite. I mean, you're in for magic anyway because it's Dynamite. He's just he's an incredible wrestler in his own right. As I always say, Abdonian Ace isn't just a fancy tagline you throw in there for the lols. He's a really, really great wrestler. He's a great antagonist as well, and riling up people and making them care in supporting his opponent. And he's put on a really fantastic match. It was marred in the case of a match itself because Captain Allen came out, but that continued his quest to get this Shravani. So it all made sense. Omar got distracted when he was about to hit the Thunder Gun Express and ended up losing thanks to, I think it was a super kick and then the kill shot that put down Omar for a 3 count. But yeah, this was a fantastic match. And I'll be perfectly honest, it probably was going to be my match of the night until one other match happened, which I'll get onto in a second. Actually, I'm going the right way. I'm going towards sides to Fraserburgh. I'm sure there'll be a turn off to like Whitlaw or something on the way. That'll be fine. See, the last time I did this journey home, it was the summer, and I'm just going to keep going for sides to Fraserburgh. I'll be alright. yeah, it was light, so I could get my bearings on the way back from going to the show. But yeah, we'll figure it out. So next match was the non-title tag match, the Outfit against the Wallys, and this was a nice little match. It wasn't particularly good thing because there wasn't a title on the line, but the two teams put on a really fun match, and you can't see me anymore, guys, so I will crank up the brightness when I get home and put this episode together. But some good funny bits. There was a lot of good tag team wrestling from the Outfit, a lot of shenanigans and silly bollocks from the Wallys, from Dawkins and Tucker, and it kind of continued. They've had a little bit of a run of bad luck, it seems, and they just showed that kind of dissension a little bit with Tucker trying to use Dawkins as a battering ram, and then Dawkins getting frustrated, so using Tucker as a battering ram, but then missed and ended up ramming Tucker's head into the turnbuckle. There was just a little bit of shenanigans, but it was good kind of shenanigans. It was good fun. I'm going to use that word a lot. It seems fun. Think of another word that's not fun, that isn't fun, because it's fun is what I've got in my brain. So we've got that. First half main was Conor Malloy versus Caleb for the Tri-Counties title, and I enjoyed a lot of the match. I don't think it hit the heights of Station Hotel Showdown, and there was a bit of a crowd lull during it, and I don't know, I think it's because Conor's character is still really fresh, and that little smugness, it's certainly become more put together since Granite City Showdown, but it's still not quite realised, perhaps. But the match itself was really good. I mean, it's two guys that I really enjoy watching wrestle, and the crowd kind of lulled. What I did notice tonight, there wasn't as much of your kind of regular crowd. There was a couple that I recognised, like Daniel, like Callum, and Brian. There was a couple folk that I recognised from shows, but there wasn't a big showing from the regular crowd. I mean, it was a good crowd. It was sold out, apparently. There was a couple of empty seats, but I assume it was maybe folk that didn't want a ticket and then couldn't go. But I'm going to heavy guess about 150, 175 maybe people there, and it was a nice venue. And I was speaking to Martin about this, and I was telling him that I feel old, because the first thing I noticed was to get to the venue, it's a straight line, pretty much a straight line from the entranceway, so it would have been really easy to get the ring there, because it was a straight line. And as soon as I said it, I thought, oh god, I'm 33, and then I'm admiring the layout of a venue to get a ring in. And secondly, there was no stairs, so I was like, yes, no stairs. Good days. This is a good day. So we got that. But yeah, Caleb retained. Looks like a good match, really solid match, but the crowd didn't seem to really get into the middle portion, but they really enjoyed the end portion with the Hell Ride as well. So, for me, not as good as Station Hotel Showdown, but that was a match that we didn't expect to get. And I think that probably added to the element surprise, to know what we're going to get. But no, at least I'm not fussed. I would love to see a rematch of it. I think we're probably going to see these teams clash again in the future. Skull Brawl and Flippy and Drippy. So we'll see how that goes. Interval, I got a picture with the tag team champions, Omar, who's stealing Ian Skinner's gimmick with the Coke Zero. Who likes Coke? Who likes normal Coke? Who likes to drink Coke? We can just get a team going. We've got Diet Coke, Ian Skinner, who actually doesn't, I don't think he actually likes Diet Coke, but it's a thing. Him with the Diet Coke, Omar with the Coke Zero. Who wants Coke? I mean, what a terrible thing to say on a podcast about wrestling. There's probably many, stories. So I got a picture of those guys. I wasn't gonna, you know? And then I just thought, stop being a bitch. Stop being a twat here. Go get a picture. You know, take the picture. That's what you hear. Take the picture. So I got the picture. And I'm going to have to remember to get some trophies, because I need to give Caleb trophies for... What's he getting trophies for? I wasn't doing any for the 150, for the SWN 150, but he's definitely getting a trophy for Finisher of the Year. He didn't get Wrestler of the Year because I was Emerson Jane. Tag Team of the Year. Does he get a show poster? I don't think so. That should go to Discovery. So he's got a couple trophies coming his way though. So I'll have to remember to go to Asda and use my Sharpie pen and just do what I did last year to make them up. I could probably get a few given in Discovery this year. Well, maybe. Before I go into the second half of the show, I really enjoyed watching Blue Thunder sitting quarter by, so there was no commentary on the show that was being done. It was kind of like a very streamlined roster. And so Blue Thunder was watching the matches on the stage. I was just sitting on the stage watching them. And that really was interesting to watch, because he was there. Obviously, in commentary, there's got to be some sort of unbiased involved. And you got to see him supporting the guys from the training academy and offering support to the good guys and all that kind of stuff. And that was fascinating to watch out of the corner of my eye while I was watching the rest of the show. Second half started with Captain Alan Sterling against Mickey Vago. There was a zinger that Captain Alan had, and I'm forgetting it, but he made couple people move like left and right to the side so he could personally insult someone at the second or third row, which was beautiful. Captain Alan finds new and hilarious ways just to be funny, and I love that. Like I say, I'm fairly certain that Captain Alan doesn't like me particularly, but I love Captain Alan, so we've got like a love nothing relationship going on here. Vago had Tommy Raiden. So Tommy Raiden is kind of... Right, this is the interesting about this one, is Tommy Raiden came out still with his flannel and his backwards cap and his drumsticks and all that kind of stuff. He got ridden by Alan at one point. I may have a video in the montage about it, or a photo or something, which was really showed a bit more of Tommy Raiden's character than we haven't really seen before. So that was good there. And then when the match ended, Vago gave Raiden his like cut off denim jacket that Raiden put on. So there you go, a little bit of development here, a little bit of development in the Tommy Raiden Mickey Vago relationship, mentorship that we've got going on. So that was cool. I like that. The match, yeah, like I said, plenty of good hilarity, which was just nice. I really enjoyed it. We did get handspring elbow, cartwheel elbow. I can't remember what it's called. It's late. We got one. I still don't think I saw one in Grand State Showdown. Maybe I'm just totally blind. But yeah, so we got one tonight, which was good. And we got I enjoy Captain Allen just being Captain Allen. Vago. So Omar came out to distract Captain Allen in return for earlier, and we got the stunner. 1, 2, 3. Mickey Vago wins that match, and yeah, good fun, really good fun. Next was the tag team match of Foundation of the Future against. I remember that. Right, the bit at the start was Captain Allen. He pointed out that Vago came out with a Singapore cane, and Tommy Raiden came out with drumsticks, so there was too much wood, and the referee had to go check Mickey Vago for any more wood. And that, my friends, is hilarious. It's ridiculously funny. I'm such a child for finding that funny. And then he went, weird louse, etc. because Vig was minging. That was the kind of punchline there. But, you know, we all thought otherwise. You know, we're grown-ups here. We know what was funny about that. Anyway, the ultimate match was Foundation of the Future versus William Starling and Damien. A lot of Foundation doing Foundation things, dominating the match. Damien doing a lot of fight back. We've got to see William get a little bit more of the ring than he did at Grand City Showdown as well. Match eventually ended in a schmoz when Zach Dynamite came out. I didn't realise Zach Dynamite came out for like a second or two until he kind of parted the seas. And he was all in black, which didn't help. And so, yeah, about that. During it, William Starling was determined to call Bruiser Brad Shrek. Now, Brad is a very handsome man, and I say that with no irony, and I would actually say he does look like Handsome Shrek. You know, from, was it the second one, where he takes the potion and turns into Handsome Shrek? I would honestly say that's pretty accurate. I don't know what the insult was going for, but, you know, Brad's a handsome boy. He's a handsome, beefy boy. So, not much was good. It was a good little bit of back and forth. We've got to see a bit more of William than we did at Grand City. Damien did quite a lot of getting battered. And then we got to see... I do this quite a lot now. I'm going, now, I've thought of something. So, during it, just make sure I'm definitely recording. During the beatdown of the Foundation on Damien, it was interrupted eventually by William Starling using Brad's chain to ward off the rest of the Foundation. I watched Blue Thunder again because he was on stage, so he was really close by, and he looked like he was going to maybe get involved, and I felt like there was like a foot twitching that he was going to get involved, and then William came back with the chain and that kind of stopped the attack, and made me think that maybe at Rumble we're going to get Thunder Buddies and Damien against all the Foundation, and that's your big kind of big schmoz match that you get at the Rumble. So maybe not. The raffle, I felt so bad for Martin doing a raffle colourblind. I felt really bad for him. He struggled, but people won. There were some mega prizes, like hospitality tickets, because it was done for charity. It was like hospitality tickets and all that kind of stuff for Peterhead Football Club. And probably should have entered the raffle. And then the main event was Ronan King against Aspen, and possibly. And I say this when I love that main event at Harvey Arke, I would say this is Aspen's best defence that I've seen. This match, just like I said, the match I really enjoyed was Omar versus Zach. I thought that's a fantastic match, one of my favourites. But this one just tipped it, and it's because it was. Peterhead show, you're thinking, all right, okay, there's no chance of a title change, but this one made you think there could be. Made you think, maybe we actually could see a title change, because it got really close, and that's testament to both these guys putting on that match. And you think, oh, they're not going to do a title change just on a random show. Like, it's going to be one of the big five. One of the big five shows you usually see a title change. But we've seen like the Tri-Counties change hands at Inverurie. We've seen that happen. So it's not against Preston. I think, I'm trying to remember rightly, I think Andy Wilde won the Unspeed title, I think it was like in Ellen or something, when it was him and Scotty Swift are battling. So it's again not against the grain here for title to change hands just on a kind of a random show. But it became really close. It shows the growth of Ronan since he debuted in 2021. end of 2021 to the start of 2024, how good he is, you know. He's got the cocky character, sure, absolutely, and he's doing all these cocky things, but he's a very good wrestler, and he makes you believe in his character. You believe that he's this cocky scumbag, you know. He's just gonna antagonize you and do it with such a smug look on his face, and it's testament to how good he is. He's put all these pieces together, and from training from WrestleZone, from going down to Glasgow and training down there, and picking up all these pieces that he could to put this character together, to put Ronan King together, and this is not anything I haven't already said. I should have taken that turn off to Bebsy. It's not something I haven't already said. I've said how good this he is in every podcast or anything that I've been able to speak about Ronan King in. And this isn't a match that I enjoyed just because it's got Aspen in it, because the evolution of Aspen as well. He came out and I hadn't noticed if this happened in Grand City, but I think he had pink hair. I remember in a podcast with him, he talked about he liked to, once he kind of fully evolved a particular chapter of his character, he stripped back his entire back down to the monotone to build it back up again. And he came out in Peterhead in white and black to build it back up again. I love the Skull Brawl side of Aspen that's been brought out in WrestleZone. I think it's very similar. I think he's been doing Discovery and all that kind of stuff, but in WrestleZone, he was side to gash. He's kind of been the wrestler. He's a champion. He didn't really change up much of himself. People just started to cheat him, and now he's a bit more playful in matches. He's a bit more. He's almost like, and I'm not going to say daddy because I don't understand the term enough to do that, but there is kind of a big dad energy about Aspen now. He's kind of like these are the kids, I've got to put them in line kind of thing going on, and I love it. I just love that kind of that evolution a little bit. He's letting the fans in, high fives and all that kind of stuff. He's letting the fans in. I could be totally off base with all of this, but this is just how I've witnessed it. In WrestleZone especially, he's just got this kind of this new energy since the Skull Brawl union in the Northeast. Like I said, it could be all stuff he's doing in Discovery, it could be all stuff he's doing in Community Pro or wherever else. He's doing a bit of the wrestling, but this is just how I'm seeing it up in the Northeast. By a fantastic main event, the chops were blistering. Hopefully they do justice in the montage. Eventually, after promises to the children in the front row that he was going to do a tombstone, they eventually did a package tombstone to Ronan and retained. But this was an absolutely fantastic main event. Like I say, one of the best, personally one of the best in Aspen's reign so far. It was fantastic. And if it wasn't for that match, it would be Zack Omar as the match of the night. So it's a very, very close second for me personally. And I don't give out stars or anything like that, so I'm just enjoying it. I'm now in Facebook. I have taken a wrong turn. But it's okay. I'll find a turn off to somewhere I know. I think I would just go straight ahead. Anyway, there's Tesco. Okay. I used to come here a lot. I'm fairly certain I know where I'm going. I've only taken a possible 17-mile detour. When I go to shows, I'm so haphazard when it comes to the geography of life. And there's youths out. There's youths. Ugh. Youths. But yeah, great show. Really enjoyed it. There wasn't any like big surprises or unexpected moments. But it was Zach coming out, absolutely. But I was expecting maybe Connor and Caleb to come out in the main event, or or Ronin and Aspen maybe to interfere in the Tri-Counties match. So we did get that kind of surprises, but we had a really great show at the end of the day. So a great night at WrestleZone. I really enjoyed that. So next show I've got coming up will be Regal Rumble. That's on March 30th. And I should have company. I'll have Kelly with me. I'm very excited for that, because what was the last show she went to? I think it might have been Anarchy. So it's been a wee while since she's been to a wrestling show. So I'm glad that we're going to go see some wrestling again, because it's been a little while. And I really enjoy going to the shows with her, so that's even better. And I probably need to start paying attention where I'm going, because I am a little bit lost. I'm going to go and put the sat nav on and try and figure out how I'm getting home, because I'm now in Fraserburgh and I shouldn't be. I should be like at least in Upper Sligo by now. So I'm going to go and figure that out and get home. So. Yeah, next bit will probably be in the studio that I'll record the fall tomorrow, Monday. Have a good one. I may still be in Frisborough by Monday at this rate. Fingers crossed that I'm home. Bye.
And we're back in the studio. Hello. I say back in the studio. I'm in my office listening to the latest Mickey's Mosh Pit at the movies. I don't know why I'm doing this cheap plug, because this episode is going to come out in like a month. So go check out Mickey's Mosh Pit. In the bottom corner, you can see I'm editing the episode that's going to go out that you're listening to now and watching now. So I'm in the middle of that. I've got dog hair all over my bloody hoodie. It's great. Anyway, collective thoughts a couple days after the show. I apologize for the darkness. In the last segment, I did try my best to try and keep it I turned the brightness up all the way, and that's how it came out. It didn't really do much at all, so there's a lot of darkness. But if you listen to the audio issue in the edition, it doesn't really matter to you anyway. I got a little bit mixed up by saying Omar and Zach opened the main show. It was actually the Outfit versus the Warriors Against Low Life Entities. I don't know how my brain decided to mix those two matches up. There's a lot of great things happened. I'm in the middle of writing also the review, so I'm multitasking at the moment. That I'm trying to remember bits and pieces as I go along for this bit. But during the Omar and Zach match, there was a fantastic, and I didn't get it on video, unfortunately, but I'm sure Omar will already have it up as a gift somewhere, that he did a... Like ran to the ropes and he got whipped into the corner, did the old counter where you grab the ropes and leapfrog over, but landed perfectly to put Zach Dynamite into a reverse DDT. It was sublime, it was wonderful. Hopefully that has been put up somewhere on the interweb, somewhere for you. But I don't think there's much more to add. I think I like doing the big road trip episodes at the end of in Aberdeen ones anyway, because I do a big like 20-minute ramble of all my thoughts and feelings from after the show, and it all makes this bit almost obsolete, but I still want to come on anyway and do the, just in case I think of something in that couple days space of time. But no, it was a really fun show from WrestleZone. I really enjoyed it. I think I saw a couple of people that I recognised off the internet. I think I saw the guys from WrestlePanda as well that were in the crowd starting about, along with some of the usuals. But like I said, there wasn't that many of the actual regulars that you usually see. I saw Brian, I didn't see David, I didn't see Jonathan. It was a bit of a mix of a crowd. A lot of kids, of course, and hopefully raised a lot of money for charity. Because that was the point of this whole show, really. It was a charity show to raise some funds for Peterhead Community Council, and hopefully gets back into do good things. I'm all over the place as always when I'm coming to the talking and don't prepare. But anyway, yeah, it was a fantastic night. I'm not going to keep you any longer than you have to, because I don't think I've got any more additional information to add. Just for the podcast stuff, I have been organizing like a madman, and hopefully by the time this comes out, I'll have more stuff on the Patreon ready for you when it comes out publicly. And also we'll have stuff ready to be recorded in the coming weeks as well. Because I think at the moment, it looks like I've got a couple I'm organizing in April, a couple big ones like tag teams and factions, stuff like that. I'm going to do some multi-man ones, make use of my Zoom subscription, really, and get that done. And then we're going to have some road trips. We'll have a Regal Rumble one and a Discovery one as well. That's the hope and prayer that we'll be able to have a Discovery Wrestling road trip episode on this season. But season 7 hasn't started yet officially, but when you listen to this, it is on the road. It is a couple episodes in, and I'm excited for this one. We're going to try some things this season, along with the usual day of birth bonanza and what have you. So I'm excited for it. But anyway, have a good one, and hopefully you've enjoyed some sort of wrestling in your life. If you haven't watched any wrestling, go to a show near you. Check out our website, swnscotland.com, and find out more. Or go to Patreon for some exclusive stuff, some old stuff, stuff that's not even out now. Stuff that never went out either. There's some interviews in there that never saw the light of day that you can go and listen to, along with some things that I've found wrestling related in the past from my life, including radio shows and what have you. There's some stuff in there. But go check it out. But thank you very much for supporting SWN. I know right now our YouTube numbers aren't great. Some sort of algorithm has just wrecked it, but our audio numbers are fantastic. So I'm so glad that people are enjoying it in some sort of medium, and you're consuming some sort of Scottish wrestling content, whether it's myself or just in general. Go enjoy some Scottish wrestling. I do, and I want to tell you why, and this is why I'm doing it. This is what I do this whole thing for. Anyway, have a good one. This has been Billy. I'm going to probably go and finish writing, finish editing, and all that kind of good stuff. But see ya.